Okay, the next. As like I did with the low kicks, I can also do with the middle kicks. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to make some random combinations and then end with a middle kick. You can make a combination with one punch and a kick. You can make a combination with two punches and a kick. You can make a combination with three punches and a kick. You can even do it with four punches. Basically, it doesn't matter how many punches you do. If you end with a kick, and don't do the same thing all the time, because then your opponent will see what's happening. So, for example, I start with left hook and a right middle kick. So it's simple. One, two. Now I'm gonna make two left hooks. One, two, three. It's already different. Yeah? I'm gonna make left hook, right straight, left hook, right middle kick. Yeah? Those are the things that are important. The same thing I'm gonna do with right. Yeah? I'm gonna make right straight, left middle kick. Yeah? I'm gonna make left hook, right hook, left middle kick. I'm gonna make left middle kick. Okay? So the ways to do that is like you have so many different ways. And that's what I like. That's why if I do the same thing all the time, my opponent will know what I do. But if I do it a little bit different all the time, it will be different. Okay, now you attack me. With first with the punches and then with the kick. And you can change the kicks. It doesn't matter. Okay. I have to see what's coming. If I cannot see what's coming, that means that the move is good. Yes? Okay. Yeah, good. Yes. That was the same. No problem. Yes, good. Very good, very good, very good. You see, it's even for me, it's always to see what is coming. What is coming? It is not easy. If you do the same thing, it's easy. After three times, you know, oh, he's gonna do this. But if it's every time something else, that's what makes it difficult.